Hey guys, welcome to the stream. If you're wondering what happened to Red Dead Redemption 2, my internet cut off. Well, the stream got disconnected from the internet. I don't know why it keeps doing that.
But traffic in New York City making its way back and forth between Manhattan and the borough of Brooklyn are setting tonight. Welcome everyone, and what a game we have for you tonight as we get set to bring you NBA action on 2K Sports. Chris Webber's joining us at the broadcast table alongside Greg Anthony and David Aldridge on the sideline. This is Kevin Harper. And a quick look here at some of the numbers for Jordan.
And it's a nice month he's had. Something's got him motivated. He's become a much bigger contributor offensively. He's settled into the kind of groove that every player wants to get in.
Now let's send it down to David Aldridge, standing by from the sidelines. David?
Well, guys, we know Russell Westbrook is fearless on the court and with a sense of fashion. Growing up around Los Angeles, he said, "I felt like every day was the first day of school. That's how it was the minute I woke up." Guys, he's starting to release his own lines of clothing and accessories. I have a couple in my closet. Back to you.
Influential with his taste, for sure, David. Thank you. And tonight, the battle of offenses that can really stretch defenses thin, Chris, as a former post player. Talk about the advantages of being surrounded by great shooters.
Well, you want to get doubled. I mean, it's the best of both worlds. You can be as aggressive as you want early or late to score as much as you can. Why? Because you want that defense to try to stop you, because when they do, you just get it out to wide open shooters that can knock it down. When you get double teamed, you know, even the hockey assist or the direct assist to a cat can really get their rhythm going. And then you put the defense in the quandary. Catch 22, do they stop you? Do they go to the shooters? And when you get the defense kind of thinking off balance, like,
hey,
that,
I got the ball first.
You start to have fun. And yeah, back cuts, alley, you spin moves, dunks, drive to the hole, shooters. It turns into a fun game.
Out of options, you're right. Now a look at Philadelphia's starting lineup. Alexander is out there with Bryant. Then there's Russell Westbrook. Then it's Jordan. And it's
all right, what you got, Smith?
And for Brooklyn, they've got Porter. Heald is out there with Dennis Smith. Then there's Tobias Harris. And it's Atkins at the five, roaming the paint.
And able to pad his stats a little bit there on that play. The board and the bucket.
And you know, Greg, they'll put him in the good graces of that coaching staff, too, in my goodness.
And that's an example of playing big, adapting to the situation.
Oh, yeah, difficult finish, but if you expected him to back down, you better think again.
Now here's Heald. He had a 27-point outing in their last game against Phoenix.
So many of his points came at the line. He was trying to fake it physically. He just said, yeah, bring it.
And have to be very careful when you're on Smith Jr. He doesn't back down from the contact.
And he's got his first free throw of the game.
Two shots. Shoot two.
And the first one at the line is good.
And it's the combination of athleticism, speed, and intelligence Smith Jr. has that's so impressive. Just a dynamic point guard with loads of potential.
Both free throws good from Smith. About a minute played so far here in the first. It's Westbrook with the drive.
Hey, y'all gonna follow me?
And it's the fearlessness of Westbrook. It's really refreshing to watch. When he's deep inside, he just goes right at you.
First trip to the free throw line for him tonight.
And so far this season, it's been average at best at the line. Only 71% as a shooter.
Free throw, no good. Nets have gone 1-3 for the field to start this one so far. Yep, that one goes in there.
He was so quick on the drive, blasting through the defense.
What is going on with our defense?
Here's Westbrook. Score it. His third straight basket in three tries.
And early on, they look great. They've made all four of their shots to start this game.
Smith, the pass to Atkins. It's good, the assist that time from Smith.
And their post play has been really solid right off the bat.
The 76ers have gone 4-4 to start, so a nice offensive rhythm to start here. It's good on the putback.
You know, we talk about it all the time, guys. Those second chance buckets, always the result of that extra effort.
For Brooklyn, they've gone 3-5 shooting the ball so far. To the paint. Harris's shot is good.
Oh, no doubt that Buddy Hield can shoot with the best of them. But it's encouraging watching him share the wealth as well.
Pass to Alexander. Over Harris. Alexander gets
the ball. Oh, all right. I see you, Alexander.
He's got his second bucket tonight. Now, here is Smith. He had 16 points in the win against Phoenix.
And one of the big ways he came through was at the foul line. They couldn't contain him, and he was equally effective at scoring baskets as well as getting to the line.
Now here's Bryant, following the missed shot by Tobias Harris. From the corner, the shot by Bryant, no good.
Very dangerous to leave a guy like that open. Lucky break there for the D.
Quarter passing to Hield. Right through the D for the layup.
Yeah, he's evolving into a more well-rounded scorer. He'll really show his toughness right there, finishing off these types of shots.
And though Chris, he's known mostly for his shooting, Buddy Hield has been improving other areas as well.
So, yeah, he's talking about ball handling, playmaking. I mean, they're notably better from early in his career. He's a solid rebounder who is definitely not a weak link on the defensive side as well.
So it's Brooklyn now. 76ers getting the bucket. Passes to Atkins. For three, Smith. Unable to get that one. And the 76ers go the other way with it. Their last encounter was in Philadelphia.
And the last time these two met, they were able to get a big win because of that bench production. Second unit might be a factor in this one as well.
Well, that's just something to keep an eye on. I mean, when their reserves are operating at a high level, so tough to beat.
Westbrook, no good.
And you can see the defenders afraid to kind of get in his way a lot of times when he's on the scope to the basket. But on that one, they were there.
Hield can't hit. And it's Butler with the ball. He'll bring it up for the Philadelphia 76ers. It's
what the heck, Smith. Kobe?
It's
why'd you move? Like, the hell?
Hield. Down it goes. His third basket. He's now 3-for-4.
What timing from here. Love how he sizes up these opportunities as the pass is coming his way.
Shot from the wing. Another miss by Philadelphia. Nets leading by three. On the wing, Porter. Unloads from 13. And Butler sends it back. So it looks like the Nets will retain possession here.
No, not in my house. The kid, what are you talking about?
Here's Smith, and he makes good on the way. The 76ers decide to take their first time out here. Hey, Chris, what do you think is the best way for a coach who has lost a locker room to get it back?
You just got to be honest and open. I mean, you know, everyone's adults, and if you can't handle the information, then the onus is on that player. But just look at what happened in Minnesota last year. You know, just terrible in the locker room. It's not good for the fans, especially the hometown fans that believe in this young team. And so a lot of times it just comes down to clear, open communication.
Teams with the quickest hands in the league. The 76ers, number one.
And it's no accident to see them at that top spot, guys. I mean, great awareness and anticipation. They apply a ton of pressure defensively.
Looking to end the run. Second shot opportunity. And there's the nice layup by Butler.
Second chance points always hurt. Just not enough effort to block out.
Yeah, that's what's frustrating, because you did the job defensively to get the stop, and then you gave it right back.
Now, here is Smith. He averages about 5 points a game. Here's Porter. Rebound by Butler. Butler's got 4 rebounds in this game. Bryant and Kobe throws it down hard.
If you're going to give Bryant a lane to the rim, then you deserve to get dunked on. You know how tenacious he is when penetrating inside.
The Nets with the lead. Here's Smith, and Butler sends it back.
Let's go, Butler.
Kobe the fast break opportunity. And finish off by Bryant.
Every team looking to get easy ones in transition.
Greg, that's about as high percentage a look as you're going to get running the floor beautifully.
Now here's Heald. He's got 7. Knocks it loose and stolen by Butler. And here's the fast break. Lobs it up for Jordan.
Jordan, you're supposed to alley-oop that.
His first bucket of the game. He's 1 for 2.
And the perils of trying to defend Jordan.
Athletic. I swear, my teammates are trying to sometimes.
He wants to go. And then tough enough to take the hit and finish.
Tipped away. Here's Harris. Second chance effort. He takes it up and brings it in. Harris has got his second basket.
And they repeatedly probed inside in the first half, guys, and it's paid off.
And Westbrook gets it to go.
He's putting the hammer down. Dominant quarter for him, trying to push out that lead.
Here's Smith. And it's sent back by Bryant.
No, gimme.
The defense from Kobe.
Still plenty of time for him to contribute in this game, but it's a tough stretch he's going through.
And slam dunk by Jordan.
Yeah, just forcing the issue offensively. The great thing about Jordan, he does it while staying under control.
Here's Smith. Scores for only the second time tonight. Now 2 for 6 from the field.
Don't forget about this fella for a second. He is the definition of dangerous.
It's Westbrook with the drive. Can't hit from in close.
That's a surprise. I mean, really out of character for him to miss when the defense is not right up on it.
Good on the three-point shot.
And a real weapon of force.
Not them tying it up.
Finding the room he needs on the perimeter to pull the trigger.
Here's Westbrook. Buries it down low. Westbrook's got 12 in the game.
They have ridden him today, and it has paid off in a big way.
And the first timeout called of the game for Brooklyn. Here's one of the most versatile scorers in the game, Tobias Harris. He had some great teachers, too, including Hall of Famer George
Irving.
Yeah, well, check this out, Kevin. His father was an Irving's agent late in his career. I mean, from 8. Tobias got to train at Gervin's facility every summer. And they still work out to this day. That's a real one. Harris learned from a great how to get buckets.
Checked in. Karis LeVert comes in for Otto Porter Jr. Bryn Forbes, he's checked in for Buddy Hield. And it's Adams in for Smith. And then for Philadelphia. Freaks checked in for Bryant. James Harden comes in for Jordan. And Iverson's subbed in for Russell Westbrook. Now here's Adams. An 11-point game for him in the win against Phoenix.
And he passed the ball so well in that game, keeping everybody involved, even as he was racking up all those points.
And it's Freak missing. Brooklyn's gone 2 of 4 from beyond the arc to start the game. Three-pointer. Adams' shot is good. And the Nets lead by 1.
And he likes to get in a rhythm early. Nice triple.
Iverson against Adams, and there it is for him.
That's the 10th straight point they've given up in the paint.
Looking at Philadelphia, they took the win in their last game against the Magic in Orlando. Atkins defended by Butler. Atkins passes to Adams. Six on the shot clock. Let's a floater go. It's hauled in by the 76ers. Butler's got his fifth rebound in this one. Tries it from the top of the key, and that one's good. Freak. And now a three-point Philadelphia lead. Now Adams. The pass to LeVert. Beyond the arc. Rebound by Butler. Philadelphia leading by three. From deep, Iverson. He can't get it to go.
And he didn't punish them for the weak coverage there, but they can count on him to continue missing. The defense a step slow, and you can see the result.
Adams has gotten two of his three shots to go tonight. Pass to Alexander. The shot missing. And it's the Nets taking it the other way.
I'm back. I'm trying to get in. Distracted by people.
Already it's February. Let's see how the East is matching up. And take a look at the 76ers, earning the first place position with a terrific record. And we've seen them perform splendidly pretty much all season long so far, and they're definitely the team to beat. And of course, the Nets just need to take it a game at a time.
And for Philadelphia, they had a few critics.
Oh, come on.
Season, and now I don't think they have any. This is a club ready to not only make a deep run, but possibly win it all. You know, that's the mindset you have to have. They know if they can get
and then you're going to follow me.
They have the talent to do some real damage. But these defenders just look a bit overmatched, especially inside.
The 76ers have gone 0-for-1 at the line. This is their second trip to the line tonight.
And when you got a team percentage of about 81%, you're going to be one of the elites in this league.
Free throw, good. Freak. League is cracked down. C-Web on flagrants. Yeah. Leaving the bench. Do you think we need to be as strict about it as we've been?
Well, I'm not paying attention to detail the league is giving on flagrants. So, if you don't want the flagrants on the pass, my friend Kevin McHale, he says Rambis just ran into the elbow.
And then you're going to foul me again.
Games are too important. You don't want that flagrant one, flagrant two, a shot and the ball. It can change the momentum of the game. I think the league and the refs are doing a great job. Let's just not let those ones that are flagrant sneak in there because of flop.
And Chris, what about players leaving the bench when there's something going on?
Well, I'll tell you what, the league has always been great about that. And now what's funny is if you watch the games, there's an assistant coach that is designated just when he sees a scuffle on the floor. His only job is to run to the end of the bench and stand at the line with his arms out so no player can cross him. So not only is the league taking steps, not only are players mindful of it, but now you have an assistant coach. His only job is to stand up there and to be an obstacle so that no players can step that foot across the line. It changes series. It causes big fights. It puts fans in harm's way. And we just don't
Adams wide open. And the Nets another three.
And they're getting their points now almost exclusively from the triple. Four of their last five makes are from beyond the arc.
Okay, two hands for safety. That's what they say, right?
Now that's right. He was ultra safe with that dunk, no question. Brooklyn trailing. Pass to LeVert. To the wing on the left. Here's Kelly. I missed that time. Would have put him up.
And they had some boxed coverage that turned into no coverage.
Butler kicks for free. Back to Butler. Kicks it out to Harden.
Shoots from the corner.
Yo, why y'all acting like y'all can't shoot the damn ball?
Adams taking his time here. LeVert the pass to Kelly. That's good. And it's LeVert with the assist. Kelly's got it all tied up now for the Nets.
And really just unselfish basketball on the interior. That's the kind of pass a coach loves to see.
Controls the rebound and puts it back up and in.
Pretty much all of their buckets coming from inside the paint.
And for Brooklyn, they're shooting well right out of the gates here at around 50%. The three. Adams' shot is off. Now the 76ers with it. Here's Freak. And Freak throws it down.
Let's go, Freak.
Guys, he's not an easy man to stop when he's got the rim in his sight.
Never has been, never will be. He is a determined finisher. Now here's Adams. 11 points in the game. And he comes up with the deuce. So it's Philadelphia now. They come into this one having outplayed the Magic last game.
Yeah, those road games are tricky, but they had a good strategy going in and stuck to what they do best. Staying with your game plan is so important, especially when you are away from your home arena.
Here's LeVert. The scoring fast and furious as we end the first quarter. Philadelphia ahead. They're up by four. And the second quarter about to get started. We'll be back in just a moment. So far, halfway through the first half in this one. And guys, what's your take so far in Philadelphia?
Well, in that first quarter, they were intent on just pounding the ball down low.
Old school approach. If you have a favorable matchup inside, just keep pounding it in there.
Nets trail by four. And now, brought to you by Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. Let's reset our lineups. Taking a look at the 76ers.
All right, come on, what you got?
Jake is out there with Alexander. And there's Klay Thompson. And there's Allen.
Thanks for the rebound.
And it's Butler in at the five. There's Freak. That shot misses. The Nets go the other way with it. They come into this having outplayed Phoenix the last game.
And the bench turned up in that one. Whatever they couldn't get from their starters, they got from the reserves.
And when the bench steps up, it takes pressure off the starters. And they stepped up big in that game.
Here's Freak. After the basket by Brooklyn, and Freak throws it down.
Stop playing with me.
Automatic finisher when he gets into that area.
He is, and he picks the simple one-hand stuff to get the 2 points. Brooklyn's gone 5 of 10 from downtown tonight. 50% exactly. Adams with it. Iverson picks him up. Pass to Forbes. The three hands it from downtown. Forbes has got 5.
If D didn't do a good enough job on him, he could be an ace when he gets a good look at 3.
There's Freak. And he hands it back. The 3-pointer offline. And the guard, Bryn Forbes, won back-to-back state championships as a high schooler in the state of Michigan. After years at Cleveland State, then transferred back to the state of Michigan and played at Michigan State.
Bro, why are you acting like you can't make threes? The 3-pointers is all the way up at 100.
Kevin really has developed into a steady rotation player in the NBA. And by the way, what a knockdown shooter.
Brooklyn's gone 6 of 11 when they've taken the 3-point shot tonight. Fairly respectable. No good from outside. Philadelphia has gone 0-2 from deep in the second. Free. Fouled on the
y'all gonna foul me.
2 points, so one free throw coming up.
Coming off a big game, his confidence couldn't be higher. A coach knows
it. And that's why they're running plays for him. They're getting him the ball and letting him go to work.
The 76ers shooting their 5th free throw of the game here. Harris is checked in for Brooklyn. Otto Porter Jr. comes in for Bryn Forbes. And the 76ers also making a change. Darren Collison, he's checked in for Allen Iverson. Chris, this is a specialty of yours. Which current bigs are best at finishing contested shots right at the rim?
Oh, Well, I'll tell you this, the best big in the league last year, averaging 17 points scoring in the paint, Giannis Antetokounmpo. Yes. I mean, he'll dunk on anybody, move out the way. He finishes. What about Embiid inside? What about Gobert? What about Boogie Cousins? Should I continue? I can keep going because the big man is back, baby.
And a wide open look for Porter. That's good. And it's LeVert with the assist. LeVert's got his fourth assist with that last one here tonight. Here's Thompson. Another miss by Philadelphia.
Yo, what the hell? Three.
The pass to LeVert. And the call on the shot that sends him to the line. It's his first trip to the line. First free throw is good. And the 76ers making a change here. Lions checked in. So after making the first, he goes 1-for-2. The 76ers trail by 4. Here's Collison. It's hauled in by Adams.
I mean, that can happen to anyone, but it's ugly every time it does.
Oh, man, he's from someplace to hide, man. It's almost impossible in this guy. And I've been impressed with the unselfishness, but also giving guys the ball where they can do something with it. Yeah, he's just not giving the ball up. He's passing with a purpose, and this lead to scores.
Here's what Brooklyn's going with right now. On a heel, he checks in for LeVert, and it's Dennis Smith in for Adams. Like out of Porter, he just brings so much with his consistent outside jumper.
And guys, he's shot threes at a tremendous clip the last few seasons. I mean, really for his whole career. Sometimes can be a bit passive, so you just make sure he's involved and looking for his shot.
Well, Kevin, they would love to see every possession in with a high percentage shot like that.
Smith dishes to Kelly. Shot. It's good, the assist that time from Smith. Kelly's got the lead up to 7 now for Brooklyn. 76ers have gone 3-8 from the field since the beginning of the second quarter. And they double up. Here's Thompson. Misses, and he wants that one back. And here are the Nets. They're on an 18-7 run. It's Porter outside. Rebound by Butler. Butler's got rebound number 8 now on the night. Pass to Bryant over Porter. Kobe can't hit. And so it's Porter bringing it up now for the Brooklyn Nets. 7-point game, the biggest lead in the game. And finished off by Porter.
And you can see how Porter has worked on his game. Sometimes he flat out owns the opposition.
Philadelphia's gone 0-2 from deep here in the second. Bryant drives in. Missed the shot. He's made 3 and missed 3 from the field. Here's Heal. Lays it up and banks it in. And now it's an 11-point Brooklyn lead.
How many times have we seen a possession like that from them today? Ending with a basket, coming off a pretty pass.
Good work there as it goes. 8 points for Kobe Bryant.
Man, how about that high release Bryant has? Really helps him inside when the D there is attempting to smother him.
And it's Harris on the drive and slam dunk by Harris.
The finish was nice, but the setup was better.
Yeah, GA, the pick working to full effect before the stuff.
Yeah, coach is definitely pleased. That's the execution we love to see.
Now here is Harris following the miss by Kobe Bryant.
Yes, who cares on some shit again?
Harris has got 4 points now in the quarter.
Nicely done. They continue to attack inside, and that's 10 points in a row in the paint.
And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here. Chris, middle of last season, plenty of drama around the AD trade request. Davis wanted to leave New Orleans. Some say all publicity is good publicity. But Commissioner Silver clearly does not agree.
I don't agree either, and I think if you go back, the Lakers would say that's a self-inflicted wound, and some things are best left in the locker room. Let me tell you, every team tried to trade for AD except the team that didn't have him last year, and maybe the Golden State Warriors. So everyone was out there. It just wasn't the rumors. And so, no, you never really like those rumors. They affect young players. They affect the player that may be being traded for. They affect the home fan base. They affect everyone. So you want to try to keep all of that in-house. Some things are better left, I'd say.
And he sinks the second. Nets leading by 12. Smith the pass to Harris. Philadelphia takes possession. And let's see what the Nets have coming up. On Monday, they'll tip off a road trip starting in Orlando and going up against the Magic. And then on Wednesday, the Atlanta Hawks come to town. That will tip off a homestand for them.
And for their matchup with the Magic, this is one where it would take a complete meltdown for them not to come away with a win. Anything can happen, but I'd be shocked if they don't come out on top.
The 76ers have had 7 opportunities at the free throw line and made good on 5 of them.
What the hell? Yeah, I know 2K wants some shit.
He hits the second from the line. It's the Nets now. They lead by 11. When this game is done, they'll be off to Orlando and they'll take on the Magic. That will be a getaway game for them, a one-game road trip.
Yeah, and they're starting to warm up from the field this quarter.
Philadelphia's gone 0-2 from deeper in the second. 11 feet away. That one, no good. Excellent defense there from Smith. They double him with Jordan.
And now only one away from being in the penalty.
Here's Harris, and slam dunk by Harris.
It's easy to forget about the athleticism of Harris until he dunks on your head, and he's happy to remind you of it on that play like that.
And Westbrook, here we go. Looks good, is good. That's his 7th basket in 12 tries.
Oh, that's not the kind of interior defense you want. Way too slow to protect.
Westbrook against Smith. Healed outside. From outside the arc. Rebound by Butler.
He hasn't been able to do much damage outside the 3-point line. Just one triple for him in the game. And that was back in the first quarter.
That is good. And the Nets' lead is cut down now to just 11 on the basket from Jordan. Here's Heald, following the basket by Michael Jordan. And it's good. 2 points. 8 points for Smith.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
And Westbrook, here we go. Whistle blows. Bucket is good. And he'll have a chance at the line to make it a 3-point play. So we'll see Russell Westbrook on the line here. That one on Harris. The 76ers have made 2/3 of their free throws tonight. 6 of 9 to be exact. James Harden, he's checked in for Bryant. A free throw drops for Russell Westbrook. Brooklyn leading by 10.
Oh, we'll try that.
9 points in the game so far. That's in. That's his fifth field goal. He's shooting a hot 71%. 5 for 7. And Westbrook, here we go. It falls for basket number 9 from the field. He's taken 14 shots to get there.
He's been fantastic, but he can't do it all by himself. Some of the other guys need to lighten the load to step up.
Smith inside. 8 points for him. And it goes out of bounds. That one is off Smith. And Brooklyn making a change here. Atkins checked in. And Philadelphia has possession. Westbrook drives in, and he trims the lead to single digits. Westbrook's got 10 points now just in this quarter.
He's been dominant this quarter. I mean, he's determined to prevent the lead from getting any bigger.
Smith kicks to Harris. From 10 feet out, goes back up. Here's Atkins. Down it goes for his third basket in as many tries.
It's a +5 advantage for them in rebounding after that one.
Here's Westbrook. Butler. And Butler with the second chance points. Butler's got 6.
Oh, how about the deft touch right there, guys?
He just got that ball back up and in. Just a fingertip touch on the ball. Smith against Westbrook. Pass to Hill.
I'll be taking that.
Grabs the miss. Alexander's got his 6th rebound on the night. It's taken away by Smith.
How?
Butler against Harris. That one good.
That's some cheating ass bullshit.
14.
He's finally got into rhythm here in the second. The shooting percentage has taken a nice jump.
Westbrook with it. Now Smith defending. Misses from close range. Nets leading by 10. They get a hand on it. And here we go. Harden heading to the hoop. The shot's good on the assist by Butler. Butler's got 5 assists in the game.
Just spectacular in the open floor. When Harden's coming downhill, you're at his mercy. And sometimes I feel like people don't truly appreciate the greatness of what James Harden does. The toughest guys to check on the fast break. He has one of the best Euro steps in the game, the best footwork in the game. He'll hit you in the head for deep. You can't check him without fouling. The precision of his movements, the ease in which he scores. Come on, man.
Now here is Harris following the miss by Russell Westbrook. And Butler sends it back.
Stop playing with me.
Jordan against Hield. Alexander, no luck.
That was meant for her.
Has been building the last few years is truly remarkable.
Yeah, Kevin, it was funny because when you are achieving greatness, the critics try to diminish what you're doing, and it's just funny to me. Harden is one of the great guards of all time, no matter how you slice it.
The Nets shooting their 6th and 7th free throws in the game.
And they've had really good numbers all season from the free throw line.
Shooting 2.
First one falls for.
Yeah, nice job of drawing the contact and creating opportunities at the line.
So for the Nets, LeVert's checked in for Porter, and it's Adams in for Dennis Smith. And then for Philadelphia, Freak's checked in for Butler, and Iverson's subbed in for Russell Westbrook. Both free throws good from Hill.
And that's another area where he is just a superb player. Excellent at the free throw line.
It's Harden with the drive and the jam by Harden.
Oh, and when Harden is going strong to the rim, he's looking for the throwdown, ripping the rim down hard.
to the middle. Let's it go from 11, and it's freak missing.
Just a solid performance on the interior. The rebounding has been off the chart.
Did you see the no-look pass by Harris right there? I mean, he's a kid that knows how to move the ball.
Philadelphia's gone 0-2 from deep in the second. The three from Iverson. A rebound by the Nets.
And close to making the defense pay for the lax coverage that's in.
The Nets from three-point range.
And let's see, guys, if that triggers another little explosion from him after hitting three triples in that first quarter.
A three-pointer is right on target.
The real. Come at us, and we're coming right back at you.
Let's talk about great competition going on. That's what makes a matchup like this so much fun to watch.
Good for the fifth time in five shots. He remains perfect.
Perfect. Yeah, they got hot here in the second quarter. No wonder they're in front.
I have no idea where all this mud is.
Now here's Freak. Driving close. And Freak throws it down.
Man, he sure can get off the floor.
He's one of the best in the business, absolutely. 50 seconds left in the first half. Adams against Adams. Adams shot is off. The 76ers trail by 15. Here's Iverson. And Iverson,
I gotta stop playing and come back.
And Iverson constantly driving to the basket, using that speed and athleticism to kind of will his way to the rim.
Adams from outside, off the mark. 19 seconds left in the first half. The drive by Jordan, and it's Jordan slamming it down.
Oh my goodness, the creativity, the athleticism of Michael Jordan.
Adams, the best of four. Puts up a three, hits it from three-point range. Forge has got a pair of triples in the second half for Brooklyn.
Unwilling to let up, even for a moment. That's his killer instinct, just fanning the flame.
That's what you love about him. He shows no mercy, even with a comfortable lead.
And so we wrap up the first half. Nets lead by 14. It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Kevin, thank you. Here with Brett Brown. Now, Coach, it seemed like you guys came out a little flat. How do you get some energy for the second half?
We just got to go with the people that have energy. I feel like we are not the aggressors. We have to do whatever we're going to do through our defense.
Brett, thanks for your time. Back to you, Kevin.
All right, David, thank you. We'll be back after halftime for the start of the third quarter.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hey, welcome back to 2K Sports. Ernie Johnson alongside Shaquille O'Neal and the Jet. Kenny Smith, let's get to it. What a game it's been for Tobias Harris. He had 14 points, 2 assists, and 12 big-time rebounds. And from what we saw so far from the Nets, Kenny, what's your takeaway?
Well, they went downtown and threw a party. And fortunately, we were all invited. The key is that shooters weren't afraid to pull the trigger on open looks. And it's a blowout right now.
And over to Shaq, what did you think about Philadelphia?
Not pretty to watch how they get torched in the low post. I mean, when they were playing defense in the post, you know they are. Barbecue chicken on earth, barbecue chicken on earth. This team is going to have to up the pressure. Play more physical than the second half. Start a fight. Throw some mold. Let's go.
What is this?
And that's a wrap. With the third quarter approaching, we now send you back to Kevin and the crew.
As we dive into the second half, we'll find out if the next two quarters are any different from the first two. So far, it has been a runaway. Well, you look at Russell Westbrook in this game, he has been everywhere.
He's done a fantastic job of finding open space to operate within the first few quarters.
Yeah, the offense looks crisp. And guys are hitting the shots.
There wasn't too much drama in the first half, but maybe things will tighten up here in the second. Brooklyn leading by 14. They've got Dennis Smith. Tobias Harris is out there at Porter. And it's Atkins in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. That's the group starting the second half for Kenny Atkinson. Adams finds Smith, drills the elbow jumper. Smith's got the opening bucket to start the second half for the Nets.
And so assured, can't give an inch of breathing room to Smith Jr. That's when he strikes.
Net shooting is beautiful right now. 60% for the game. Pretty much everyone out there has been stroking it. And the basket by Harris. Harris has got 16 points.
It's a great move, and he catches the defense completely off guard.
They'd like to see a little more energy coming out of halftime on the defensive end.
And so it's Smith with it. He'll bring it up for the Nets. And Smith gets double teamed. Down low, here's Atkins, and it is pushed down with a nice jam.
Yeah, you got to appreciate the mindset of Smith. Solid at running the offense and finding his teammates who are open.
Westbrook with the bucket.
And pro move there. Finds a way to gain some separation against the much taller defender.
Yeah, showing that short area skill allows him to create some space.
Atkins, and there's 2 points. Working on the glass, paying off that time.
And he's the main reason they have the lead right now. He's been perfect from the field, literally.
Westbrook. Oh!
And you know Westbrook has an outstanding vertical. And once he gets to the launching pad, rim, he wins.
Nets leading by 16. That's a 2 from Smith. Rebound by Butler. Butler's got 11 rebounds in the game. The 76ers have gone 3 of 4 so far in the third quarter from the field. Pretty good start to the half. They get it back. Alexander, no luck. The Nets have gone 4 of 6 from the field since the start of the third. Adams. Off target with his 3. The 76ers trail by 16. Butler kicks to Jordan. That shot, no good.
Jordan, why the heck would you do that?
Shooting a high 57% from the field in the third. Up again.
Just in a perfect position to grab that rebound and then get the putback.
Here's Westbrook. He's got 26. Some solid defense from Harris.
And they've got a big lead, not just on the scoreboard, but really in the rebounding numbers as well.
2 free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul.
Harris is so quick on the drive. Sometimes defenders have to foul him and just hope he
misses the shot.
The Nets have been good at the free throw line. This one, 7 of 8. Heels check in for the Nets. And Harris drops the ball. The 76ers trail by 20. Here's Kobe. And it's out of bounds. The Nets will take it the other way.
Let's see some of the numbers here on Kobe Bryant. Unbelievable play for him over the last month. Right around 25 points per, 3 rebounds, and 2 assists. And the phrase, stats don't lie, absolutely applies here. He's been a monster on the court for this team.
And he's oozing with confidence. I mean, and it shows. Every time he steps on the floor, he expects it.
Yeah, and Smith proven to be a fantastic point guard, a terrific passer who does a great job of moving the ball on offense.
Keeps it alive. He hangs in there and catches it on the second chance points. Alexander's got 8.
I love his work ethic. Not to miss. They need both to convert.
What is this? What the heck is Sigma?
Brooklyn leading by 20. Passes it to Smith. Looking for Harris. He gets it there. And stand dunk by Harris.
We've seen Harris step up as an offensive threat. I mean, the more he looks to score, the better he is.
And the 76ers call time here. You look at Tobias Harris, he has really been playing well.
He just keeps hitting after the shot. They need to design a way to deny him the basketball. Make someone else beat him.
checked in. Tom Tinney's checked in for Philadelphia. Third quarter of basketball here in just a little under 3.5 minutes gone by. Kobe goes in, and Kobe throws it down.
And Brian, just a superb athlete. Terrific at just...
Oh, where's that paper at?
On that drive.
Brooklyn leading by 20. Here's Smith. Here's Atkins. And Chen shot. Good. He's now got 10 of 10 from the field.
And he's starting to show that killer instinct this quarter, looking to extend the lead.
And the dunk by Westbrook.
Taking matters into his own hands.
Yeah, we didn't expect to see that kind of finish.
No, but his teammates love that kind of energy, fellas. I mean, dunks like this demonstrate leadership. Tells you a little something about their team. They've been able to pull in front despite his troubles tonight.
Here's Bryant. It's in and good for his 6th field goal in 10 attempts.
Look, that's a nice play. You need low post scoring to keep your offense balanced.
Westbrook against Smith. The pass to Hill. Back to Smith. Nice pass. Right into the rack perfectly for the layup. Smith's got 14 points.
Working on his interior game, Smith Jr. is very aware he has what it takes to score from there.
Brooklyn leading by 20. And here's the fast break. Porter leading the way. Here's Alexander, guarded by Porter. Here's Thompson, and the shot goes down.
A good size for the two positions, but Clay's been able to compete and play through the contact.
Smith against Westbrook. And it's
Smith. Oh, come on.
And he did everything he could to make that shot as difficult as possible.
Excellent team, avoiding fouling and got in the perfect position to alter the shot.
Now, here is Smith following the miss by Russell Westbrook. And again, no good by Brooklyn. On the wing, Bryant, covered by Hill. Good on the bucket. And that's 15 points for Kobe Bryant.
Well, it's just been one of those nights from he got into the floor of the game and has not lost his touch.
Hield against Westbrook. Releases. Hield with the bucket. He's got 15.
If there's ever a successful shot that still gets your coach mad at you, that's the one.
And Westbrook throws it down.
Puts the D in a tough spot when you have a point guard who can throw it down.
He really does, D.A. He really does put pressure on him.
And guys, it's clear, though, he enjoys showing off his athleticism. The D can't give him these opportunities.
And Brooklyn has possession after the Sixers pick up two. Atkins defended by Butler. Back to Smith. 6 to shoot. Sends it back.
Let's go, Butler.
76ers on the break. Here's Kobe. Good for his 8th field goal. He's attempted a dozen shots.
Well, he's perfect from the field this quarter. He's given fits out of it.
And Smith gets double team. Pass to Atkins. Inside. And that's good. Great pass to get it done. Smith's got 6 in the quarter.
A physical player. Even when you hit Smith Jr., he doesn't blink. Wills those shots in.
And the 76ers call time here.
Adjustments are a part of the game, and the coach sees something he doesn't like here.
Yeah, I like the chess match that's going on here. Each team trying to find and exploit the favorable matchup on the floor.
Hold on, you guys. Still trying to catch up.
And 10 of their last 12 coming off assists.
Here's Freak following the bucket by the Nets. That one goes. Count it. Freak's got 23 points.
Who knows what this score would look like if he wasn't on his game tonight.
Healed outside. On the wing. He's off on that one. And Philadelphia the other way now. They'll be off to Charlotte for a game against the Hornets. That is game three of this four-game trip. That one falls. And here's Heald. He'll bring it up for Brooklyn. It's an 18-point lead. Here's Forbes. That one is good again. He sits right from the floor with the basket.
And they're passing the ball very crisply here.
Here's Freak. And Freak throws it down.
Oh, boy. To be young again.
Makes you nostalgic, doesn't it? Here is Forbes. He's got 14. Kicks it to Heal. Atkins passes to Heal. Atkins defended by Butler. Shot clock at 5. Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot 2 free throws. The Nets have gone 9 of 10 from the line, so making the most of their chances. And he can't get the first one. Tobias Harris is checked in for Brooklyn. Adams comes in for Buddy Hield. The 76ers also with a sub. Jordan's checked in. So neither attempt will fall that time for the 76ers trail by 18. Butler attacking Freak. The shot's good on the assist by Butler. Butler's got his 6th assist on the night.
Taking things into his own hands. He's been a beast this quarter.
Here is Forbes. Passes it to Atkins. Now here is Harris. Defense is right there. And oh boy, a lot of contact there, but he gets the call and will shoot 2.
Oh, man, the defenders have to be more cautious when guarding Harris. He is constantly looking to draw contact on the shots.
He's gone 2 for 2 at the line so far. Taking 2 shots. That's good from Harris. Both shots good from the stripe. The 76ers trail by 18. It's Harden with the drive. Good. Harden's got 6 points in the quarter.
Quick and strong and determined. Harden has it all when it comes to scoring in the paint.
And the pass to Harris. Sinks that one from the post. Harris has got 10 points here in the second half.
And that's what you want to see. Good fundamental sound basketball with the basketball.
And so is Brooklyn with an 18-point lead as the quarter comes to a close. And we'll see if they can keep up their tremendous shooting. They've been dialed in so far from the field. We've got more in store for you right after this.
Hold on, guys. I got to make a phone call.